Mary Bell Chilton is an amazing person.
My mother is someone who is tremendously curious, and she loves to work on a puzzle. What is the ultimate puzzle out there? It's got to be the incredibly complex code of DNA.
As a PhD student and a postdoc, I was intrigued by bacterial transformation, a process for correction of mutations in certain types of bacterial DNA.
You know, Agrobacterium, Agrobacter tumefaciens, the name tells you a little bit, right? Agrobacter means a plant bacteria. And then tumefaciens means something that generates tumors. These are little pimple-like things that you see on the leaves and on the fruit and things like that, little pimples. And those are the tumors, they're called galls.
She really set out from the beginning to prove that Agrobacterium does not modify the genes of its host plant. She thought that was a ridiculous idea that people were bandying about, and set out to prove that that wasn't true, and discovered, much to her surprise, that she was wrong and they were right, and it does change the genetic structure of the host plant. That's really where the field of genetic engineering of plants came from.
The Agrobacterium cells contained a plasmid, and when we looked for parts of the plasmid in the transformed plant cells, at last we found that a small part of the plasmid was there.
Once it became apparent that Agrobacterium knew, if you will, some secrets about how to modify DNA that we didn't know about, she began to wonder how we might be able to harness that and turn it into a technology that we could use to modify the genes of plants.
So along comes Mary Bell Chilton, who figures out with research that she did how to open up that round DNA and then insert into it genes of interest. Imagine that this Agrobacter is like that drone, and the payload is the DNA inside of it. It comes to the plant, and then the bacterium, you know, insinuates itself, its DNA into the plant, and the DNA then becomes part of the plant's genetic machinery.
The numbers of food crops grown using this technology is pretty amazing.
So the typical grocery basket in America, the meat that you're eating was raised on these transgenic crops as a result of Mary Bell Chilton's work. The eggs that you eat was produced by chickens that were fed on a diet that is derivative of Mary Bell Chilton's work. The bread that you're gonna eat, the corn tortillas that you're gonna eat, your shirts that you're wearing, the pants you're wearing, is going to have that of Mary Bell Chilton and her colleagues working there.
There are billions of people around the world who deal with some type of food insecurity at some level, and the potential to address those needs, I think, is one of those things that that is the real importance of where this technology can lead us.
Stakeholders, you and I collectively as humanity, we have a stake in this, because these foundational, fundamental discoveries, whether it is about vaccines or about how to deal with hunger or how to, for example, put a man on the moon. We never know. When Mary Bell Chilton did her original work, she had no clue that there was going to be a public good, because she's looking at it from the perspective of that fundamental question of how DNA does its business.
You never know where a particular type of research will lead us. Sometimes that things that get studied today may take dozens or 100 years to become apparent why they're important. She's just somebody who's been tremendously fortunate to get to see the importance of her work be revealed within her own lifetime. She's definitely a really remarkable individual, and I know my whole family is tremendously proud of her.